What happens when a few hiccups become a normal thing? Is it time for us to call the doctor on the Glanbia Performance nutrition brands? So my plan at the beginning was gonna be just to rip off the Band-Aid really quick at the beginning of this video, but I decided maybe a little bit of storytelling would be more appreciated by you. So I'm gonna be taking you through a nice leisurely stroll through the Irish countryside per se. And we're gonna start at the top here, Glanbia as a whole, and just kind of look at their 2019 quarter three earnings. You guys remember from some of the other Glanbia videos, they are an Irish-based publicly traded company. They're not a US-based publicly traded company. They do have a large amount of operations and revenue that does come from those operations in the United States, but they are an Irish-based company. And because of that, they have some different reporting requirements and things in which they lay out. So on the quarterly numbers, they don't really break out a lot of just like the strict revenue numbers like they do on the US side of publicly traded companies. So I'm not gonna have those numbers for you. And since I'm gonna be running through some of these numbers, I know it was easier for me last time to just kind of have my computer here and have some of the notes and the numbers there so I didn't have to memorize all of these things. I don't think you guys noticed too much of a difference between me reading some of the numbers and me memorizing them and having that on my videos. So Glanbia's 2019 Q3 earnings was up 16.9% on a constant currency basis, revenue as a whole. Of that 16.9%, you had 11.3% that was coming from acquisitions. So this is gonna be from both Watson and from SlimFast, since both of those happened, I believe, in like Q4, maybe Q1. So you're gonna have some comparable differences that is comprising that growth number. You also have a 2.4% volume growth, and then you have a 3.2% price increase. So all those sound great, right? I mean, those are some really strong numbers. This is definitely a journey that you guys are enjoying while you guys are sightseeing around the Irish countryside. But let's kind of continue on this journey just to give you guys a little bit of a reminder. Again, Glanbia as a whole is made up of two different large divisions, if we're talking about wholly owned divisions. And I'm gonna cover this kind of first one, and this is one that I don't spend a lot of personal time really thinking about outside of just them having that as an asset and just kind of understanding maybe how it's doing overall in the market because it's a part of the supply chain. But Glanbia Nutritionals is made up of their nutritional solutions business and also their US cheese business. And on the numbers here, they were up 25.4% year over year on a revenue basis, that is on a constant currency revenue basis. Of that 25.4, you had 9.3% coming from volume increases. You had 12.2% coming from Watson, the acquisition that I talked about earlier. They also had a 3.9% positive price increase. So overall, again, tons of really good numbers. Everybody's enjoying this journey around the Irish countryside. Now, the other side of the overall Glanbia portfolio is the Glanbia Performance Nutrition brands, the end consumer brands that a lot of you guys that are listening to this probably are very aware of. If not, I'll just kind of run through them real quick. You have what they call lifestyle brands. That is made up of Amazing Grass, Think Thin, or what they call Think Now, and then SlimFast. The other side of that is what they consider now like sports nutrition brands. That is Optimum Nutrition, that is BSN, that is Isopure, and that's also ABB or American Bodybuilding. And then they also have two international properties. They have NutraAmino, and they also have a kind of a e-tailer slash private label brand called Body and Fit. And if we're looking at Glanbia Performance Nutrition's revenue gain year over year, you saw that it was a 16.5% increase. So again, this is quite the journey. I mean, these numbers are impressive. These numbers are something that everybody should be paying attention to. These numbers are just quite honestly impressive, especially when we're talking about a multi-billion dollar business that is focused around active nutrition, nutritional supplements, sports nutrition, those types of categories. But just as this trip across the Irish countryside seems to be one for the ages that you're gonna be talking about your whole life, you see this weird sign ahead that says sheep crossing. And to your surprise, when you're laughing a little bit with your significant other, you realize there is actually a ton of sheep ahead, and they are really blocking the only road in and out of your desired trip. This is what's happening right now with the numbers that I'm about to share. So of that 16.5% growth of Glanbia Performance Nutrition brands, let's kind of see what that is comprised of. You have 25.8% coming from acquisitions, SlimFast. So we're already well above the 16.5% growth that I talked about. So the growth is coming from SlimFast. It's not coming from their existing brand network. But just so you guys can know the other numbers that comprise this growth rate, you have a 7.9% volume decrease, and you also have a 1.4% price decrease, which is a little bit better than it has been, but not at the point where Glambia thinks it'll be in quarter four with some of the price increases that they've been able to implement over the last quarter or so. So like I kind of mentioned or alluded to, most of this growth, all of this growth in a sense, just from a pure numbers perspective, is coming from SlimFast and that acquisition of SlimFast that they had right about a year ago, actually. I think they announced it in October of 2018. So it's been in their portfolio now for a year. This next quarter, it won't be a big swing in terms of comparable growth rate. But there is kind of this tale of two cities that are happening with the Glambia Performance Nutrition revenue. And if you guys watch some of my GNC videos, you guys know I use that term a lot because GNC does have also a tale of two cities when we're talking about domestic revenue and then we're talking about international revenue. Glambia's is kind of flipped, and we're talking primarily that the international segment of their business is where the struggle is at. And this comprises of about a third of Glambia Performance Nutrition's revenue. Glambia C-Suite spoke extensively around a few trouble regions or countries in which they do a lot of business. It's an important region or country that is a part of just sports nutrition in general or nutritional supplements, and they're kind of struggling for a number of reasons. And the ones that they initially kind of alluded to is Brazil, the Middle East, and India. And anybody that's been in the business for long enough know those three regions or countries are very large regions and countries for the categories in which Glambia Performance Nutrition is operating within. So you have about, I think they said about 10% of Glambia Performance Nutrition's revenue comes from those regions or countries. And they're highlighting some currency issues with ours strengthening, also some tariff issues coming from the US, because most of the Glambia Performance Nutrition products are coming from the United States. So you're dealing with an export-import type of a situation there. Glambia is not particularly producing things in country at this point. They are talking about doing that. And I think in India, they're doing some manufacturing in country, also dealing with owning some of the distribution and supply chain within that country to alleviate some of the problems. And they're looking at that across a bunch of other regions. They just need to be extremely kind of fluid in the way that they think of things, because each particular region or country has their own kind of set of challenges, and they need to be kind of agnostic to what solution sets are out there to make sure that they're maintaining growth and being a market leader in all of those countries or regions. Another problem area that they mentioned was around Europe, and that was mostly around just a channel shift. Something that's happening in Europe, most European countries, is people are going digital, just natural kind of progression in terms of that area that's lagging a little bit in terms of what the US is seeing. So you're seeing a lot more direct-to-consumer or digital sales, marketplaces, and things like that. So Glambia is needing to shift a lot of their attention towards some direct-to-consumer sites. They also have an asset, Body & Fit, that I talked about. It's an e-tailer that they are investing in. They are revamping. They are rolling out in a bunch of other countries a lot more aggressively. So you're going to see them utilize that asset a lot stronger, and they think they'll be kind of fine in European region. So I don't think that's going to be much of a long-term threat, especially if they can utilize Body & Fit the right way. But if we're just talking about Glambia Performance Nutrition's portfolio, and specifically if we're talking about Optimum Nutrition, there's a ton of brand equity in Optimum Nutrition internationally. In a lot of countries, a lot of regions, they are the leader by far, or one of the only people in some of those very minute or small countries or regions that are tough to get into. So there's not much of an issue in terms of like brand equity on Optimum's side. Glambia Performance Nutrition is obviously much more than Optimum, so they need to be thoughtful in the way that they attack that in an international sense. But brand equity overall, I don't see any issue from that perspective right now. I think it's more of the tactics and strategies are not really matching up globally and locally in terms of which regions they need to kind of adjust things. This isn't like a brand issue. This is more of a tactical or strategic issue that needs to be overcome in the future. Now, shifting to the other side of North America, this is 2/3 of their revenue. This is where they are headquartered. Glanbia Performance Nutrition is outside of Chicago. So this is where they have a lot of influence on their business. And there's some different things that are going on Glanbia within the North American business that they highlighted on their call or their earnings report. They did talk highly about the initial relaunch of Think from Think Thin, and they're saying they're having some good feedback from retailers and customers from some of the new products, just more aspirational, gender neutral type of a brand approach. And they're saying that they think this is gonna really catch on, regardless of how highly competitive the nutritional bar area is. You've seen me talk about this on multiple different videos about how competitive the nutritional bar business is. You have tons of very big portfolios like the Active Nutrition portfolio at Post Holdings, or what they call Bellring Brands now, talking about how tough the bar business is comparable to the drink business. But Glanbia is saying, hey, Think is doing pretty good here initially. We think this is going to continue, and we are confident that this rebrand was the right direction. They also made a few comments just about the lifestyle brands as a whole. So there is Think within there. They also have Amazing Grass and then SlimFast. Overall, they're saying the lifestyle brands is where the growth is on the US side. And they're saying those are performing extremely well. From what I can see from my side, I would agree with Glanbia. I think that those are their three brands that are doing very well. They also are saying, just from like a portfolio as a whole, most of their growth at right now, where they're most confident where their growth is coming from, is with new mass retailers or existing mass velocity, sales velocity, also from just online sales growing and online sales becoming a bigger part of their business. They also talked that the club channel is going very well, but they said the growth rate is going to be decelerated a little bit from the year before. They kind of also made a little bit of a comment that Optimum Nutrition, the core product, the Optimum Nutrition Ready to Mix Whey, gold standard whey, that is the top product in the portfolio, has been doing well within the club channel. So they're not really concerned about the club channel. They just think that there's going to be some needed kind of tactical or strategic things that they're going to need to do on the club account side to make sure that they're capturing Q4 revenue when they are kind of stocking up and getting ready for Q1 for the people that are buying, that new consumers, mainstream consumers, are getting ready to get in there and do their New Year's resolutionist thing. And then alternatively, Glanbia continued to make commentary around specialty channel being challenging, specialty channel decreasing. That's not anything new for people that have watched a ton of my videos. You guys know that I have been really hot to tell you guys how the specialty channel within nutritional supplements and sports nutrition have been performing, but it is a very challenging business, retail business right now. Finally, at the end of the video, where I normally kind of add my commentary, add my thoughts here, I'm gonna shift gears a little bit and tell you guys that I would rather you guys watch a podcast that I do with the fitness informant, Ryan Buckeye, depending on how you know him. But we do a podcast called Two Guys, One Shaker Cup. It's a conversational podcast around different fitness and sports nutrition, sports, ton of different other kind of topics. But a recent episode that we did covered this hypothetical question: if we could be the CEO for the day of any brand or business in our space, which one would we be? I picked Glanbia, so there are some interesting thoughts in there about what I would do if I was the CEO. It was not comprehensive. Obviously, the point of that podcast is more conversational and not be a full comprehensive type of a podcast. So I'm gonna definitely need to add some commentary to that specific video. I have a feeling, based around some of the engagement we have with that video and just the attention in terms of views, downloads on Apple Podcasts and Spotify Podcasts, that I'm gonna need to put another video together. But I want you guys to click the pop-up here. That is the video that I'm talking about. You guys can watch that. And I promise to add an accompanying video on my own channel, this channel, before the end of the year. But just to kind of whet everybody's whistle a little bit, to make sure you guys don't think I'm just leaving you on a cliffhanger, I'll give you guys a little bit around my maybe top five areas that I would focus on, my biggest kind of strategic areas that I'll probably more than likely really focus on in that video. First one is around Glamby Performance Nutrition's brand portfolio, so just really doing a comprehensive assessment of that brand portfolio. This kind of fires off a ton of chain reactions that would be chain reactions from like mergers and acquisitions type of commentary to product commentary to branding commentary. So there's gonna be a ton of things in that first kind of strategic initiative that I'm gonna talk about. The second one is around some of this like by country, by region, international, like sales strategy, distribution strategy, just how all those things need to be set up correctly. Third one is gonna be around Glamby Performance Nutrition's like digital talent, creative talent, just how to address that in a way that makes sense for the future of the business. Number four, we're gonna be talking about Glambia Nutritionals, one that I don't talk about a lot, that segment of the business. Some of their partner pricing and the way that they address working with partners, AKA the competitors of Glambia Performance Nutrition. And then finally, we're gonna be talking about a subsection of Glambia Nutritionals, the nutrition solutions business. And I wanna kind of cover some things around innovation cycles or exclusives and just how those things need to be handled to give Glambia Performance Nutrition brands a head start in a way. But again, more detail on that soon when I do put out that video. Make sure you guys are subscribed to my channel so you guys don't miss that video. It is definitely gonna be one that is good, one that I've been thinking about for a while. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you wanna help support me, make sure you guys hit that thumbs up button on this video. If this is the first time you've been introduced to my videos, would love for you guys to be a part of my community by subscribing to my channel. I upload several videos just like this weekly. And if you guys want to connect further outside of this platform, I do include all of my social media links down below. I just want to thank you guys again for your time. Hopefully I gave you some value in return, and we'll see you guys on the next video.